Hello everyone, welcome to Talent Battle. As you know, Goldman Sachs has announced their recruitment program for 2021 and 2022 pass out students. So now in next few videos, we will focus our attention to the placement preparation related to Goldman Sachs only. In this particular video, we will look at one earlier asked coding question in Goldman Sachs. All right. So this is the coding problem. The name of the problem is array special product. Problem statement is, implement a function which, given an array of integers, returns a new array for which every index carries the value of the product of the remaining elements. So for example, if our given array is 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, then it should return 120, 40, 60, 30, and 24. Why it is so? Because at very first position we will exclude this one and write down the product of all the remaining element, that is 3 into 2 into 4 into 5, that value is 120, so we have written 120 here. At second position we will exclude this 3 and write down the product of all other remaining elements, so that will be 1 into 2 into 4 into 5, that value is 40. At the third position, output value will be 60 because that is the product of 1 into 3 into 4 into 5. So that is why we have written 60. At fourth position, the value will be 1 into 3 into 2 into 5. So that value is 30. And at last position, we will exclude this last element, that is 5, and the product of remaining elements, that is 1 into 3 into 2 into 4, that value is 24. So that is why this is our output array. In the similar way, if our array is 4, 10, 3, then it should return 30, 20 and 40. Again, I will explain it in a bit. That is, at very first position, we will exclude this 4 and write down the product of these two elements, that is 10 into 3. Now, 10 into 3 is 30, that is why we have written 30 here, and so on and so forth. So, I hope you have got to know what exactly is asked from us. Then the function description is, the function find special product accepts the following parameter: an array of integers input of size n, and the function must return a new array of size n in which every index carries the value of the product of the remaining elements. So now the input format is given. First value will be n. So first line specifies the number of elements on the array, and next n line contains each element of the array. Okay. In the similar way, output format is also given. Output format is, we have to print n integers on n separate lines, and each integer represents element of our output array. So now this is the important part, that is constraints for the program we have to write. The very first condition is, division operator cannot be used. Second condition is, the expected time complexity of our program is strictly big O of n. And the third condition, which is related to the values of the variables, so the value of n lies between 0 to 5, both included. Value of each element in array lies between 0 to 10, both included. And so that is this I and I, input of I value will be 0 to 10. And of course, I will be less than n and greater than 0. So these are the conditions. As you can see here, the constraints for variables are pretty small. N value is only up to 5 and input of I value is only up to 10. Even though the condition for time complexity is strictly limited to big O of n, we can make use of another additional data structure. So there is no limit on space complexity because these particular variables are pretty small. So if needed, we can use additional data structures. That should be clear looking at these very small ranges for variables. Now this example is given. So first element is 5, that is the value of n, number of elements in our array. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the values of each element of array. So for this particular input array, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the output values will be 120, 60, 40, 30 and 24. Now, as I have explained you earlier, at very first position, we will exclude this first position, write down the product of all the remaining elements. So product of 2, 3, 4, 5 is 120. For this second position, we will exclude this second position and write down the product of all the remaining positions, that is 1 into 3 into 4 into 5, that is 60. For third position, again, we will exclude this third position and write down the product of remaining, that is 1 into 2 into 4 into 5, that value is 40, and so on and so forth. So after understanding the problem statement, now let us discuss the solution to solve this problem. The very naive approach which can come to mind is as follows. suppose this is our array, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For each particular position, we will iterate a loop over all the remaining elements. So for very first position, we will iterate a loop from second position up to the last position, and the product of all these elements, that is 2 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5, that value 120 will be written in the output array. Now again, for the second position, what we will do, we will run a loop from beginning to end. Whenever the index value is 2, we will just exclude that value and write down the product of all the remaining elements. In the similar way, for third position, we will again run a loop from beginning to end. Whenever the index value will be 3, we will just exclude that position and write down the product of all the remaining elements as it is. So that value will be 40, so on and so forth. Now the problem with this approach is the time complexity for this case will be big of n square, and the condition that is given to us, that expected time complexity has to be big of n. Okay, so in this particular approach, what we are doing, we are running a loop over n elements for each of the positions. So that will be n positions and running a loop over n elements for each position. So that is n into n. So the total operations will be n square, and the time complexity will be big of n square for this particular approach. So obviously we have to come up with the better solution to solve this particular problem. Now another approach can be, first of all, save the product of all elements of array in one variable. Suppose let us call that variable as total product. So in this case, that total product will be 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5, that is 120. And for every particular position, what we will do, we will just divide this total product by that value. So for first position, we will divide 120 by 1. So that value will become 120 itself. Okay, so that is why at first position in our output array, the value is 120. That is the product of all the remaining elements. Again, for the second position, we will divide the total product, that is 120, by the value at that particular position, that is 2. So 120 divided by 2 will be 60. And indeed, the product of all remaining elements is 60, so on and so forth. All right. So this can be another approach. But again, as you can see, the constraint which was given, that division operator cannot be used, is being violated here. We are dividing the total product at every particular position, so we cannot use this approach. Now, in our final approach to solve this problem, we will take two separate arrays, that is left product and right product. The values at each position in this left product array will be the multiplication of this particular position and all the numbers present to the left of it. So for very first position, that value will be 1 itself, because there is nothing to the left of 1. Now for second position, the value will be multiplication to the left of it, that is 1, and this particular element, that is 2. So 1 into 2 value will become 2. For third position, it will become this particular 2, that is the product to the left of it, and the element itself, that is 3. So 2 into 3 will become 6. After that, at fourth position, the product earlier to it is 6, and the element itself at this position is 4. So 6 into 4 will become 24. And at last position, the product to the left of this particular position is 24. And the value at this particular position is 5 itself. So 24 into 5 will become 120. Alright, so these are the values in our left product array, 1, 2, 6, 24 and 120. In the similar way, let us write down this right product. As you can guess from the name of the array, now we will store the multiplication of this particular element and all elements to the right of this particular element. So during this left product, we iterated through beginning to end, so from 1 to 5. But while calculating this right product, we will iterate through end to beginning. So we will iterate through 5 to 1. Now while thinking about this last position, that is 5, there is nothing to the right of 5. So we will just write 5 as it is, the product of itself. So 5 into 1 is 5. After that, for this second last position, product of all the elements to the right of it is 5, and the value at this position itself, that is 4. So 4 into 5 will become 20. After that, at this particular position, the product of elements to the right of it is 20, and the value at this position itself is 3. So 20 into 3 will become 60. Then at this particular position, the product to the right of it is 60, and the value at this particular position is 2. So 60 into 2 will become 120. And for the last position in our end to beginning iteration, the product of the right elements is 120, and the value at this particular position itself is 1 in our original array. So 1 into 120 will become 120 itself. So our right product array is also complete now, and we have already created this left product array. Now let us create our final output array based on earlier created arrays, that is left product and right product. Now the value at each particular position in our output array will be multiplication of left product value for that position and right product value for that position. So for example, at very first position in our output array, let us consider these two positions, that is the very first positions in left product array and right product array. Now for very first position, product to the left of this first element is nothing, that is 1 itself. And product to the right of this particular position, that is this position in a right product array, product to the right of it is 120, this second element here, it's 120. So left product into right product will become 1 into 120. So that is why the value at this position in our output array will be 120. Now for this second position in our output array, let us look at the second position in our left product array and right product array. Now the product of all the left elements of this particular position is 1. That in our left product array, you can see here this 1. And product of all the elements to the right of it is 60, which is derived here in the right product array. So the value at this particular position in our output array will be left product into right product, that is 1 into 60, and that value is 60 itself. Okay. Now let us talk about this third position in our output array. For that, look at third position in left product array and right product array. The product of all the elements to the left of this particular position is 2, as you can see here in left product array, and product of all the elements to the right of this position is 20, as you can see in the right product array. So left product into right product, that is 2 into 20, that particular value will become 40. So we will write down 40 here. Now for this fourth position in our output array, let us look at fourth position in left product and right product array. Now the product of all the elements of to left of this position is 6, as you can see here, and product of all the elements to right of it is 5, as you can see here in the right product array. So 6 into 5, that is left product into right product, that value will become 30. And for the last position in our array, in our output array, 24 into 1, that value will become 24. So that is why we will write 24 here, and this is our final output array. So the 120, 60, 40, 30 and 24, this is our output array, and we know that this is the right answer because it is already given here. Here is the code for this problem. As we have to only write the function for the program, I have not written the driver code. Here the function name is find special product, parameter is one integer array whose name is input, and the function is returning one integer array, that is our output array. Then I have taken these two integer arrays, left product and right product, length of which will be input length plus 2, and the output array, its length will be same as the input array. Now this input dot length plus 2 is taken just to handle the corner cases, that is the very first position and very last position in case of left product and right product arrays. After that, we are filling all the elements in our left product and right product array as 1. So we are using this arrays dot fill method, which is present in java.util package. Now in this first loop, we are iterating from I is equal to 0 to I is less than input dot length. and left product of I is equal to input of I into left product of I minus 1. So we are filling the values in left product array. And in the below loop, we are iterating from I is equal to input dot length minus 1 until and unless I is greater than or equal to 0. And we are decrementing the value at each particular iteration. And right product of I is equal to input of I into right product of I plus 1. So we are filling the values in the right product array in this particular loop. Now after these two loops, that is left product and right product, finally we are filling our output array. Now for filling this output array, again we are iterating from beginning to end, and output of I is equal to left product of I minus 1 into right product of I plus 1. So whatever will be this value will be filled up in output of I, and at the end of this loop we are just returning this output array. So as you can see that there are no nested loops here. The time complexity for this particular program will be big of n, and at the same time we have never used any kind of division operator here. So our both the constraints are satisfied, and this program will give correct answer.